Welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today we're gonna play with eyeshadow and we're gonna play with my gorgeous Gone Rogue palette by Lois Cosmetics. We're gonna use these gorgeous colors I already have in my head what I'm gonna do. So yeah, I'm not gonna swatch it as always. I don't know. Because the best way to test eyeshadow is on the eyes, and that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna try some colors on my eyes, so please, if you would like to see what I'm gonna do, then stay with me and please subscribe to my channel, hit that notification bell, hit a like, give me a comment, it would be amazing. And yeah, let's just get into this tutorial again. I'm gonna go with voiceover, so in a second you're gonna not see my voice move, but still hear my voice. So yeah, I hope you enjoy and have fun with it, and I'm gonna have fun with this palette. I know what I'm gonna do, so enjoy. So we're gonna start with the color Nonconformist on my E42 from Sigma, and all in this gorgeous palette, the Gone Rogue palette by Lois Cosmetics. And we're gonna put this first gorgeous dark purple shade from the inner corner until the outer corner of my eye, with a little curve to follow my eye and eyebrows. A little bit. It's gonna be a high one, it's gonna be a big one, and we're gonna go cut a crease like you can see in the thumbnail. I hope you enjoy this one. I still don't know for sure about this look. I don't know, it was a lot of fun to do as well, a lot of fun to try to see how what in my head was came out in the end, but I don't know. I just don't know about this look, but I'm gonna post it because we'll see. If you guys like it, a couple of my Patreons did, so decided to post it anyway. But I don't know, there's something about this look that I just don't know. I'm sorry. So yeah, we're gonna put this like a winged out look, so this color is now gonna completely wing out almost into my hairline, connecting to the top purple. And you can see at the moment it's a little patchy, but don't worry, we'll work this all out. We're gonna keep blending as we always do. And I don't know, this look, I saw a version of this look on Instagram. I couldn't find it back, so I'm very sorry for that. I couldn't find who posted it first, I'm sorry. So I just, but so he did it, it wasn't him, and he did it with different colors a little bit. It's not looking exactly like he did it. It's maybe because that's why I don't like it or so, I don't know. And I had this look in my eyes, it just annoyed me that I couldn't find it back. And didn't make a screenshot. Normally I always make a screenshot if I copy someone's look, but I don't know. I'm very sorry. So if someone knows this kind of look, where it came from, then please do tell me. I would like to tag them in my video afterwards in the subscription if necessary. Because it came out different than his, definitely. But I don't know. I'm going to say that a lot probably in this video. I just don't know about the end results. But like you can see, look at that color, that dark purple, how it comes out of this palette. Really love it. I know Lois Cosmetics is not a big brand yet, more indie brand, but I like to support those a little bit and show you this palette. And it's just so incredibly pigmented. Going a little bit more into my inner corner with a little curve in it because, that's what I did on the other side, and now I have to match them, of course. So yeah, and keep on blending until I like the situation. Now we're gonna go in with the color Underdog, this gorgeous lighter purple one on my E27 from Sigma. I'm not holding it right, this is a very small flat brush, and you can see that very well, but this is really good for precise if you use the flatter side. And we're gonna put this on top of the other colors, of the color Nonconformist. It's gonna be on top, on the top, and on the bottom line. So the wing is gonna be it underneath it, and here it's gonna be on the top of it. To be honest, I really like this color as well. This purple, it really works well together. Blend them out really good. So yeah, it took me quite a lot of blending to do, but that's maybe because I put it on the purple a little bit too strong. I should have blended it out like I did with the other palette in the black, because Lois has another palette, the Rose Metal palette, and I did that on Valentine's Day. So if you want to see my look with that, with gorgeous pinks, then please go check that out as well. It would be amazing. But this color is just going on like, I don't know, these just shades I feel like butter. It's really amazing. I think, to be honest, I have four Jeffree Star palettes and quality. She gets close, she really does, it's really good. So yeah, hope she comes for and makes more makeup. And I would really love to have her liners and her glitter. I don't know how you call those things. Liquid glitter pots as well would be amazing. It's not glitter pots, it's different. I'm sorry, but yeah, they seem really good. I want to try those as well one day. But yeah, like you can see now, we're gonna blend it underneath on the bottom line, the wing. I want to make a nice wing on it. I don't know. I quite like it. The colors are blending really well, like you can see on the top already, and here as well. Yeah, I keep adding more pigment because, but yeah, that's the way I like it. I wanted this look to be fierce, and it did came out fierce, to be honest, because that's how it looks. If you're wondering where I'm looking, I have my tablet on and I'm watching a live on, this is Kylie B at the moment when I'm doing this, because that's the way I love doing my these extreme looks. Just play with my makeup and then afterwards talk you through what I've done. So yeah, this Kylie B is amazing as well, so go check her out if you want to. She does amazing makeup. The live she did was together with Carrie, and she's also really amazing, and also has a YouTube channel, Carrie K. So yeah, try to find them. I hope I can. Don't forget to link them, because yeah, I talk about them, so it would be amazing if I link them. Both of their channels, they're doing amazing as well, and all makeup content, to be honest. We both do makeup, all three of us do makeup. And they just like me have a Kylie has like me also have a Patreon where I'm part of, because yeah, I like to support my amazing friends, and that's how I feel like, even though I've never met them. But don't worry, as soon as this corona is over, I'm gonna try to meet all of them. It would be amazing. So yeah, we're gonna keep blending until I have the required result. The color was a little bit more to the pinky purple as I thought it would be, but it works out well. But just to tell you, I don't know, it felt like a little more blue purple when I put it on, but if you can see it here blended, it looks more pinky purple. But it's really gorgeous, it's perfection. I mean, my favorite color is pink, so yeah, I love it. And I must say, the purple eye looks come really good for me. So yeah, that's this shade on. Now we're gonna go in with the next one, and this is the color Misfit, and I'm gonna put this on my M562 from Morphe, and we're gonna blend this again up on top of the other shades. So on the top we're gonna put it on top, and on the bottom we're gonna put it on bottom, because yeah, that's the way I think the look should be. So I'm gonna blend it again. Look at this gorgeous purple of purple pink. It's just, oh, I really love it. Look at the pigmentation with just one swipe with a little brush. This is a very small brush from Morphe, which I quite like for detailed work. Really do good, works well. Yeah, but then again, I do love work playing with makeup. This is one of my favorite things to do. And since I'm at home, not working, I have to do something. So yeah, why not make my YouTube channel and have fun with makeup? So yeah. If you're watching this and you're still got here, don't forget I'm going live on Thursdays doing the Mitchell look. As long as he puts them out, I will planning on doing a live on them, just because, and it's easy and I like the looks, and I get to try new things and new stuff every month. So that's every week, which is quite amazing to try new ways of doing my makeup and everything. I quite like it, so yeah. I'll have fun with that as well. So if you want to join me in a live and talk to us and everyone else, we will be there and play with makeup. So yeah. Again, look at this color. It just blends out so nice. This palette is really amazing. If you want a good pigmented palette, and not too expensive, they were £19.95. So per step, he has two of these palettes now, and yeah, I really like them. They're really, really good. To be honest, I didn't pay the money for it, but I would have planned on paying the money for it. I just had a makeup friend, Missa, from Make Me Up Missa, who gifted them to me, which is amazing. So yeah, thank you for that, Missa. I'll try to link her channel down below as well. Not that she's gonna get any followers from me, because probably all my followers are already from her. And we're gonna back in with the color Nonconformist, which I already started a little bit in, like you see previously. And now we're going to go back in with the color Underdog, just to keep on blending these shades together. And I felt like they had to go more in my hair, apparently. and a little bit on the top as well, because yeah, we just want to see this shade as well, and I felt like it did disappear a little bit, but not too much. But never wrong to re-intensify shade. Sometimes you just have to, but that's with all shadows, I feel like. Sometimes they work and sometimes you have to blend a little more, but yeah, I don't mind blending. I love playing with makeup, so yeah, for me this is a good palette, and yeah, really pigmented, really amazing. Now we're gonna go back in with the pink, the color Misfit, again on the same brush, the M562, and keep blending it into my hairline apparently. And then we're gonna cut my crease, and we're gonna use this gorgeous color from P. Louise. This is the basic, and this is in a color green with Envy, and this is gonna be an #7072 brush that came with my Mitchell paints. But it's really good, really fine, really flat, and I really do like it for this kind of application. So yeah, made good brushes, P. Louise. And I really, really love these the paints a little bit better than these basics, but it makes the color more intense because you already have the color that you want to put on top, on the bottom, underneath it, so it works really well. Of course, I could clean this all up, but I don't know, I feel like a necessary step. And way too much work, so that's why I never do it. I just keep using these paints. I have three more on its way, thanks to an amazing friend. So yeah, three more colors, and it's gonna be of the skin finish, they're called, I think. No? Something like that. Oh, no, crisp finishes. Sorry, crisp finishes. And yeah, so I hope those are just as good as the Mitchell paints. And it would be amazing to have a little bit, because I can use them as a liner and my waterline and as a base, so that's quite amazing. So I love to collect all the shades when the time is right and I have the money for it, so it would be amazing. But for now, we're just going to do it with the colors I've got and just mix and match and see. And of course, we can call these our cream products, so you can also, I think, as you mix them to get different colors, but yeah. I can see it has a nice opaque base. These are a little less opaque. The paints and the crisp finishes are a little better with that. But this works really well as a bottom shade underneath it. So yeah, I'm looking around. I forgot to cut a piece out. Oh well, I'm taking a different brush. This is the a brush from Jessup. It's a liner brush, small one. I'm going to use it to make the lines a little bit more precise. I did not use this on the other eye. For some reason it worked way better on the other eye, but oh well. And now we're going to go in with this gorgeous green. Look at it outside the box on my 237 Jessup brush, which I of course always use to pick on color. And oh, look at that shade, and look how it comes together with this base underneath it. I just love that. They intensify the shade even more when you put them on. So yeah, I quite like it. It's a lot of fun. It's a lot of fun to play with makeup, at least in my opinion. So yeah, I love using different kinds of things and picking up my makeup game. In the end, I thought maybe I should have put a little liner in between those, because there's a lot of green. But oh well, it was already on there. I do like to look. I'm not 100%, I don't know. Yeah, sorry. I'm just posing this because, yeah, I love to play with makeup, and sometimes you have to do it even if you're not 100% satisfied with the look, I think, at least, to see what you guys think. But at least you can see really well how the shades work with the way I put my makeup on, so that's a good thing, right? And yeah, I'm going to keep packing this gorgeous color on outside the box. Look at the green. Oh, it's just so pretty. I really like it. It's just so good. Yeah, let's put on a little bit more and keep on packing this on until I have the required gorgeous color. Oh, look at it, it's just really nice. I love this green, it's really good. Can't wait to try the glitter one as well, Gone Rogue from this palette. But today we went for green, because otherwise it would have been not as extreme. Going back in with the color Nonconformist, just to blend it a little bit stronger and of course a little bit sharper with the same brush I used before, the E42. And yeah, just keep on blending it in. I really do enjoy enjoy playing with this palette, because oh, look at those colors. And I figured out I did my other eye and I went higher on my other eye, so I'm correcting that, putting a little bit more base on and a little bit more of the green shades. Look, I'm showing you now, sorry, I forgot. And yeah, just make the shape the same as the other side. Sometimes you have to correct it and then go back in with the green, the outside the box, to put a little bit more on, because yeah. And now they're equal again. Looks so weird when your eyes are not the same. But yeah, like you can see, with these bases, you can just put a little extra on and make it work. Now we're going in back in with the color Nonconformist and blend this all out on my E42 brush from Sigma. Now we're going to go a liner brush, and a liner brush, liner. This is from Essence. Gorgeous purple one, just for the waterline. I could have used a little darker purple, but I don't have that, so that's what we're doing. And I don't know, I do have a liner, different purple. I didn't use it, but it's a pot liner, and this is always easier. Now we're going back in with the color Nonconformist, but on a different brush. We're going to use my 234 gesso brush and make the under eye just the same colors as the other things I blended out above my crease and my wing, to make everything work together. And again, these shades, even on a set base under my eyes, it just works so well. Just those colors pop so amazing. And then we're going in with the color Underdog. Again, this is just the same brush which I cleaned on my color switch. I feel if I do it, and because I use these colors, I feel like if I do it under my eyes, because of the fact that it's already set and I use the same brush, it just blends better, because a little bit of the previous color is still on when I use it on the color switch. I don't know, for me it feels better than doing it differently. Maybe it's nonsense, maybe I should do the same on my the rest of my eyes, but I don't. This is the color Misfit, again on the same 234 brush, cleaned on my color switch, and then just blend this in, and to make it with a wing, cohesive with the wing. Yeah, I can see this palette is so amazing. The colors work so well. I'm so enjoying this palette, and thank you Lois for making it, because it's just extraordinary and amazing. And we're going in with the last color. This is Rare Treasure, and it's going to be on my GS30 from Morphe. And we're going to put this gorgeous gold in the inner corner. Look at that shade, and on my brow bone. Really intense. These shades really are gorgeous. I felt like it cut it off a little bit, that blue or that green. So mixing it with this gold really seems to work really well. I'm putting it a little bit on my brow bone. Look at that, gorgeous. Oh. I should have cut it out. Oh well. And this is my lashes.
Well, that's me all done. And I'm not sure about it yet. I don't know. It looked kind of cool when I had it in my head, and it still looks cool, but not as different than in my head. I don't know. I like it. Oh, lipstick on my teeth, sorry. What do you guys think? Well, I think I liked it if I post this, because I'm not sure if I'm gonna post this yet, but oh well. But to be honest, it's not the fault of the palette. It's just, I don't know. I just don't know. But the palette is so good. Look at those purple shades and how they blend all together. And that green. Oh, it's gorgeous. And that gold in the inner corner. Oh, it's perfect. The colors of the palette is amazing. I'm definitely going to play this palette more. Try more looks with it. Yeah. I like the palette. It's really good. I just don't know sure if it will be on the internet. But we'll see. Well, if I put it on, that means my Patreons decided that I should post it, because those I'm going to ask right now on Telegram. So if you want to join my Patreons, the link is down below. Meet my amazing ladies that already follow me from my community. They're amazing, and it's so much fun to talk to you all in the Telegram app. So yeah, if you like that, please join. And of course, if you can't, or if you do, or if you want something else, please also just subscribe to my channel. Hit the notification bell, give me a like, give me a comment, would be amazing. And yeah, I know this is not very long in an outro, but I like to keep it a little bit short sometimes. I hope you like the look. I'm still not sure about it. We'll see what my girls think. And yeah, I'll see you in the next one. I love you all. Bye.